Yeah. Well,
by Ralph.
Well, Ralph, he's a graduate here, and when he did graduate from UNL, it didn't cost him anything.
Uh-huh.
It was free education.
And that's what he put on the Carillon.
Yeah, exactly.
And, you know, thank you for the free education.
Exactly. So as a way to give back, he donated money for the tower, and then again for the planetarium. And so we started, ground broke here in 1957, which was quite good.
The year I was born.
Well, it's also the year the space race began. You know, when Sputnik got launched.
Right, right.
And so we opened our doors. We officially opened and had the first show in March of 1958. So our history is tied in with the space race itself. When this opened, you know, the dome is still the original plaster dome. That's what they had at the time. All the seats were circular seating. I think there were more than maybe 120 seats, I think. It was all circular.
Okay.
And in the middle of the floor, it's no longer there, was a star projector. A star projector. And at the time, it just stood there fixed in the middle of the room, which would have been right here.
Yes.
Fixed right here. Eventually, 10 or so years later, then it... A cavity was made in the floor, an elevator shaft for one that could lower and rise. So the shaft is still there, kind of filled up a little bit. But the machine that then was there, we had for more than 45 years, I believe. And then it eventually just kind of, the cost of keeping it up versus what we're getting out of it didn't quite go there again. So it just was eventually removed. What we do now is what's on that pole there, is a projector on that pole. So we do full dome video. Which is video intakes the whole dome, where it makes it feel more immersive, like you're there.
Yeah.
And that's what's common for a lot of planetariums, too. And of course, now the seats are unidirectional. That's how the shows are made. But gosh, yeah, in the early days of this facility, it mostly was kind of a novelty. It was just, it's a place you can go indoors during the day and see the stars, and you had some people kind of walking you through some constellations and, you know, planets that are visible out there. And that was it. It was all it was, just the star ball, and that was the presentation. And eventually got, you know, as the space race kept unfolding and exploration continued in sets too, like when we had people on the moon, for example, we had projectors strung all around the circumference of the dome, give you panoramas.
For 25 cents.
Oh, that's hilarious.
Yeah, it's interesting. A school teacher brought her class here when it opened, and she happened to have the first ticket. So then on our 25th anniversary, she returned it to us. And like, well, this is pretty cool.
At the time, had a little piece going, you know, to celebrate. And here's a little bit of history of the place, too. But I think I got it pulled up here.
At the dedication of his planetarium, Mr. Mueller expressed his views on the value of the facility.
I'm very proud and very happy to have had a part in bringing this planetarium into being. I have an idea that it may well prove to be the most exciting, most versatile, and most efficient teaching tool that has reached this campus in some time.